and welcome to us 22.
Please make sure all mobile devices are switched off. Photography and video recording is strictly prohibited.
Please be advised, this show may contain strobe lighting and smoke effects.
Thank you and enjoy the show.
Please be informed that this show contains depictions of drug abuse as well as mentions of domestic violence and abortion.
Cheese, they haven't got anything else.
Did you not get any butter?
No, but I think it's a pickle.
Branson, brilliant.
Bryce, we didn't want anything this time, didn't he?
Looks like a bomb of rotten fruit, doesn't it? Not that you want to eat it.
Where are you going?
Tomorrow.
You got anything? What about your mum?
Tar's mum will be alright. She'll probably clear up herself once he's gone.
Stay in for him anyway. Right. Best we can do for me. Clear off. She won't have anything to tie us up with your bastard then, would she?
Well, that's what I'm hoping.
Naughty!
Why not?
Not here. Not in Barry's garage.
But you might never see me again after.
No. I didn't want it to go any further.
Fine. It won't go any further then. My name's David. But Gemma calls me Tar because I'm always saying to her, stop smoking and you'll get tar in your lungs. I'm off. I'm leaving my Leonce. I'm off to Bristol. My dad beat me up yesterday. It wasn't the first time. Why? Well, I cleaned the house because my mum's always too pissed to ever do it. He was just going on at her for using me like a skivvy. She was screaming at him for getting between her and her son. I couldn't win either way, so I'm off. I'm off to Bristol.
Last night, in the garage, we never did anything. I mean, obviously I wanted to. And like, it would have been a nice way to say goodbye. Poor Tari could have done with that. I only didn't do it for my parents. I wanted to be able to say, look, this was Tar, my boyfriend, and he was in some really nasty trouble at home. He'd been beaten up for the nth time, and he just needed someone to stay. So was that human or what? The only mistake I made was that I put my parents before Tar. Could we make that same mistake twice?
Your father's right, Gemma. There have to be rules. Surely you can see that.
Yeah, but you don't understand. He needed someone to stay. But there was no sex. Honest, all right?
Liar.
Oh, just drop down dead! I locked myself in my room, and I tried to take over the world with music.
I'm sorry, Gemma. I'm still upset there.
I'm sorry, Tony.
You know you're still my number one, Daddy. Have you two made friends now?
Oh, yes. We've just discussed what we're going to do next, won't we, Gemma?
No, you're going to have to be in the same future, Gemma. There'll be no going out in the week. Me and your father expect him every evening, and you are forbidden to see David.
All we'll do is allow to hang up by the seafront.
Your other privileges are withdrawn for the time being, too.
What other privileges? Breathing, using the bathroom.
On Friday and Saturday night, you can go out, but you have to be back by 9 o'clock.
Can we not make it half 9, please?
You promised to make it half 9 sharp, okay? And the Saturday job is finished. Just till you get back on track.
You guys just think I can't be trusted. I did everything I could.
Fast.
I've been feeling pretty down being in Bristol. I mean, sleeping rough and on my own, it was really depressing, but after the call, when I walked away from the phone box, I noticed the dandelions. And they'd always been there, it's just I hadn't noticed them before. It was like a solid mass of just bright golden yellow. Wild dandelions, not put there for me to look at, but there because they wanted to be there. All along the grubby street, it was just a blaze with yellow, and everyone was walking up and down without even noticing them. It sounds stupid, but it was like the flowers had come out for Gemma. I love yellow. It's the colour of sunlight. And I stood there, staring at them, and I got this idea for a painting. A dandelion. Just one huge, bright yellow dandelion. It would have to be a big painting. And I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna give it to Gemma when she comes. And it just felt like my big, happy moment came swooping down to me. So I reached up to grab hold of it, and off I went. I felt great again. And then it hit me. I had nowhere to live.
Well, here it is. No doubt we've been waiting for. Gemma Brogan's practical handbook to running away from home. A step-by-step guide. One, you'll need clothes. Plenty of towels and underwear and other personal items. A personal stereo, sleeping bag, paper and a pen. Money, your father's bank card and PIN number. Two, your wits, you'll need them. Three, think about it. What is the first thing your mum and dad's gonna try and do? Get you back, of course. It'll be police! It'll be, oh my God, my little girl, she's been abducted! It'll be, what if some dreadful pervert is at her right now? What if she's lying murdered in the town's local rubbish skip this very second? And it never, ever occurs to them that maybe, just maybe, little Lucinda got so fed up with Mumsy and Dadsy, she decided to leave on her own accord. So, don't want every copper in the land on your tail and pictures of you plastered all over the town's local newspapers, you'll tell them exactly where you're going. Four, this is where the pen and paper comes in. You'll take it out and you write them a note. Tell them no hard feelings and that you hope they'll understand, for that you're not coming back. Five, book the coach using your father's bank card. Six, step on the coach and run. Thank you very much.
Of course, property's always been a rather strange concept for me, especially when I find a house stands empty and there's people sleeping on the streets. I found a really nice 19th century terraced house at the Montpellier, the Inn of St. Paul's. Come on up. Always delighted to meet a new member of the squatting movement.
Thanks.
You'll be delighted to hear that we're opening a new squat right here in the Virgin Territory. That's Bonnie.
Watch her.
That's Jerry.
All
right. I'm Richard. We're anarchists. And you?
I'm Tar. Just Tar.
Don't let me see the light on the street. It's best to lie low for a couple of days until we're established. You lot alright? The idea is to get established as quickly as possible. You know, it's a lot harder to eject us if there's a house full of stuff already.
Wow. I think what you're doing here is fantastic.
So, when were you 16, Tar?
Oh, I'm not 16. I'm only 14.
Oh dear. You should be locked up.
Who?
Your father, what's he done to you?
That means he can't sign on.
Yeah, you've been begging. I really want to get a job.
I just have to be a parasite of a bus for the next couple of years.
One more won't make any difference.
I can bring in a bit of work from the bicycle shop.
Perhaps I could teach Charles some shoplifting techniques.
Oh, I don't think that would be a great idea. I mean, if he gets caught, we'd like to be sent over for the care. We don't want either of those, do we?
My girlfriend wants to be here with me as well.
Oh, how old is she?
The same as me.
14.
Yep, yeah, she doesn't look it.
She looks 16.
You're asking a lot of her. She's got to give up her parents, her education, everything for you.
No, it's not like that.
Do you want her to come very much?
I love her.
He loves her.
I mean, you can have a look at her.
You are one of us, though.
He's only 14, Richard.
So? You've fallen at any age. How old are you always falling at level 14?
14, Richard. She's only 14. She's not coming here.
Can she not come, Richard?
I'm sorry, sir. Tea?
This is how I did it. I hid my bag in the garden a few houses down on Saturday night. Then, in the morning, shower, breakfast.
Where are you going this weekend?
Downtown, maybe?
I expect that boyfriend of yours is dead by now, sniffing blood, taking drugs. Stay out of trouble, Gemma.
Bye, Mum. Bye, Dad.
Bye.
On the way to the station, I stopped by the post office and I posted the letter to my parents. Then, I stopped by the bank, got 100 quid out. It was no sweat. Then, got to the coach station, stepped on the coach, and the coach took off. And it was as simple as that.
They're really fantastic. I'm eating, Mum, really. I'm looking after myself. I'm all right.
Mum? Mum, I'm sorry I went away. I didn't mean to. I didn't want to. It's just... Mum, talk to me, please.
I can't say much, David. He's upstairs listening. He's starting to beat me. I've never been so scared. Every night he gets so drunk, and I never knew what he will do next. It's so lonely. I can't get the housework done, darling. I'll try, but you know what he's like. So fuzzy, so angry when things aren't right. It's not his fault. I've been a bad wife and a bad mother. You shouldn't have let me, David. You know that, don't you?
Yeah.
You know how much I rely on you, and I've been trying so hard. Oh, darling, how could you?
Mum, stop crying, please. We'll talk about it. Is it bad? Mum, is he hitting you a lot?
Please come back, David, please.
Okay, alright, I'll come home. Mum, I'll come home. It's not forever, alright? I'll come home.
When?
As soon as I can. As soon as I can, Mum. There's just something I gotta deal with first.
You could leave now. Get up the phone box, get a coach.
I haven't got any money.
Hitchhike.
Mum, I'll come. As soon as I can.
And you haven't got any money. But I thought you said you were right. Where are you, David?
Mum,
where are you living?
Mum, I can't tell you right now.
Don't you trust me, David. Don't you trust me, darling.
The coach trip literally took hours. I was sitting there, wetting my knickers the whole way. Every time a police car drove past, I thought they were gonna pull us over and arrest me and take me home. Then, at last, we got to Bristol. Tara!
Gemma!
Tara,
Gemma,
I miss you so
much! Come on, you've got to see the city.
I made him walk me around a bit. We went through the town centre to the docks, and I just fell in love with the place. It wasn't big and busy like you think a city's going to be. No one was desperate about anything. There were weeds growing out the walls and people weren't rushing. I cooled down and I started feeling really mellow. I mean, I was still high, but it was okay to be high. No one was bothered about stopping me. I didn't feel like I was going out of control. I remember thinking, I'm gonna like it here.
Oh, Tar, we're free. Free. You and me, free.
Yeah, but, you know, they've got some men. They aren't really nice people.
Wow.
I want you, Tar. I want you now.
There's so many people around.
That's right. Because there's always later on.
That's right. That's right, we've got all night and all day.
Oh, Tar, all night. A lovely present for you, Tar.
Hey, come on, I can't wait for you to meet them. Guys, this is Gemma. Richard, I really need to fix this door.
Sorry, Tar.
Gemma Brogan, hiya.
That's Bonnie.
Hi.
This is Jerry. And that's Richard.
Hiya. Good to meet you.
Is it the fashion to be nice here?
Gemma.
Are you joking?
It's very dry, I'm afraid. Where have you been, Tar?
We've been sightseeing.
Richard made lentil bake.
Oh,
Molly, it's okay.
Sorry, Richard. Sorry we missed you.
It's okay, Tar.
So, how long are you planning to stay with us, Gemma?
I don't know. I just don't know. It depends how you all treat me.
Come on. What do you think?
I'm going to help you stay safe. My parents, they'll be grinding their teeth, raging around the house and phoning all my friends because I'm a whole hour late.
Grab me a pen or a black. I mean, haven't you ought to ring your folks up and let them know you're right?
Well,
Why?
I mean, they must be feeling awful. The least you could do is let them know you're okay.
And tell them what? When to expect me back? And where to send the woolly vest?
No, no, no. Like I said, just let them know you're okay.
I think that would be best.
Hello?
Gemma? Where have you been? Where are you now?
I'm all right. I'm just...
You're quite sick.
It's only 10:30.
It's 11 o'clock. You were supposed to be back 1.5 hours ago. I thought we'll get back past it.
Look, I'm ringing up to let you know that I'm not going to be back tonight.
You better come back tonight. Picked up some of those seafront friends again, have you? It's not good enough.
Please don't do this to me. No, we're having a great time, thanks, Dad, yeah. Big kisses to Mum, so I'll speak to you again tomorrow.
Why are you speaking to me like that? Are you being sarcastic? Gemma, what's going on? Let's just overlook this slip, and you come back within the hour so we can discuss.
No, we've already eaten. We had baked potatoes and beans for tea, yeah. So I'll give you another ring tomorrow, probably.
Gemma?
Bye, Dad!
Gemma?
Is everything okay, Gemma? Is everything okay at home?
Look! I've done it! Is that not enough for you?
Back in a minute.
Go then.
You've got no clothes on?
That's my present, Tom.
Oh.
Have you got anything?
Fuck.
Do I have to do everything?
Sorry, I'm so stupid. I'll be back.
Oh, no, Tom! Oh, I don't want to be using boring old anarchist condoms.
Has anyone got a condom?
You can't, you're too young,
Tom. No.
I might have one somewhere.
He's too young, Richard.
Well, so it's better to be safe than sorry. I mean, we don't want any unwanted pregnancies now, do we?
Yeah, right.
Richard!
Thanks, Rich.
Good luck, Tom.
Sorry it took so long.
What happened?
They were just a bit reluctant to lend them, yeah?
Why?
Well, you're only 14. They're just worried about you.
Forget the picture.
Do you not want to anymore?
Never mind.
I love you.
Shh, don't say that.
Dandelion.
What's that supposed to mean? Ladybird.
Why ladybird?
Because they're pretty and they're red. And you like dandelions a lot.
Dandelion.
Ladybird.
Dandelion.
Ladybird.
It's a stick-up. We're off to be the banks. It's where a stick-up ought to be. No Bonnie and Clyde, and no gangsters, and the IRS, and bang, 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 and you're dead! More like Robin Hood. I mean the Disney version.
Probably 2 seconds.
Where's Diana, did you say? Go back to bed. My tools are Superglue and Subversion. No one ever gets hurt. Everyone always has a great time. Even my victims. They get down for work. When you're walking down High Street in Bristol, there's always so much going on around you. Bunch of shops, for example. I'm vegan myself, so you know, it's a bit of an issue. Streetlights blazing away, burning all the fossil fuels. Banks and corporations investing in death and disease. Chemists selling cosmetics that have been dripped into monkeys' eyes. Or the opportunity for volunteers to go around spreading some political awareness. I never met the stars. It was a lovely night. Come on! Let's do it!
Change. Time to spend. Thanks, Dad.
Gemma!
Babe, come on.
I haven't paid for my tea.
Fuck it.
Where did all this come from?
Stop. This is practically being unfaithful. You're smudging my lipstick.
Understand. It's just to free up as much space as we can.
Yeah.
but we're having a party. Why build all this if we're just going to leave it? You look really weird, Sal. Are you alright? Is you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine.
This is unreal. This is a party. And they're running away for my last night on Earth.
Hey Gemma, are you okay? You alright?
Just shut up! Just leave me alone. I sat back and I started to feel really weird. Like, really weird. I'm stoned. I'm stoned out my fucking head. Same effect as she does, you know? This girl, nothing mattered to her. All the rules, the do's and the don'ts, she had none of that. And I knew straight away that I wanted to be myself just as much as she was herself.
Hey, what's your party like?
Great.
Can I have some of that?
Yeah, sure.
Gemma, there you are. We went out to have a look at the new squat, but I couldn't find you. Are you okay?
This is Lily.
Hi.
Those are really nice boots.
Are they?
Yeah, I love them.
Tars the one I ran away with.
Oh, right, yeah. That's great. Everyone should run away.
Oh, yeah?
You did the right thing. I did when I was 12. Did the right thing for Gemma too.
Yeah. If it wasn't for Tara, I'd still be at home going mad.
Yeah, why? Leave the bastards.
Tara, you really did it. You really did it. You broke the door down. Brilliant, brilliant. Yeah.
Yeah. Brilliant, man. You did it. I love you, man.
It's all right, Tara. It's all right. Everyone was staring at us.
Douglas. Let's go. Come on, this place is dead anyway.
But all our things are there.
They'll be here tomorrow. You can get new things.
Yeah, you put your order in.
We'll get one. Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did it. You got away. You did it.
The the bloody titanium man, Tyler, the titanium man!
He really did the most amazing thing, Tar.
And I don't know how anyone could be so strong. And you're here and the rest of your life is going to be so great. And I love you and you are so sexy and strong. And I don't know how anyone could ever resist you. You're so great!
You
are so sexy and strong and a titanium man.
You're right! I did it! I got away from my parents! I did it!
Woo!
It was a weekend. Not that I care what day it is. A day is just a day. We got out of bed maybe 1 o'clock. I had a bit of business later on. But until then it was okay. Sitting around, listening to music, people watching. That's half my life. We stayed up after Ty falling asleep. And Jems, she was telling us all about it. Him and her, how he loved her, but she didn't love him. But she didn't want to hurt him because she liked him so much. all that stuff. Basically, Jems, she was feeling a bit tied down. I could see what she meant. Tal had a hard time. He just wanted to lay low for a bit. But Jems, she wanted to take the place by storm.
Hey, Jems, why don't you come live here with us?
Yeah, why not?
Do you mean that? Do you guys really mean that?
Yeah.
I'd love to live with
you. And it just felt right, you know? As soon as the idea was floating, we all knew it was right. We got into this big hug on the sofa. Welcome home, Jems. And I rolled a giant tent skinner to celebrate. After, me and Lil had been chasing the sofa when Jem had fallen asleep. We were doing too much, really. We've been binging all that weekend. And it's important to come down slowly.
Hi, Etta.
Hello, Tar, how are you?
Alright.
Where's Gemma?
She's not coming back.
They're scum.
They look a bit scummy, but no, they're not really like that.
Tar, I wouldn't want to find one of them in my shoes in the morning.
But I like them. Oh dear.
It's Gemma that I really blame.
It's probably for the best, woman.
She just wants to fly.
That girl, oh my.
So do I, Richard. So do I. Oh dear.
Come with me.
So, how's Gemma?
Oh, she's great. She's fantastic. You know our Gems. Don't get all hung up on the romantic love stuff. I can't go on without her. My life is at an end. Oh, whoa, oh, whoa.
What?
She's been missing you. We all have. And me. You're home.
Gemma!
I missed you so much. I'm so amazed at how much I missed you.
For you.
What is it?
Well, what is it?
Heroin.
Is it really? Gemma, is it really heroin? Gemma. That's important smoke.
Hey, what are you doing? That's cars.
I don't know where that came from.
Go on. Try it.
No.
Try it.
No.
Once. Try everything once.
Aren't you going to be a junkie? That's car. Are you a junkie?
No, I'm not.
A little bit of heroin isn't going to turn you into a junkie. You've got to think like a junkie to be a junkie.
You don't need junk to help you.
All these things about one hit and you're a junkie for life.
It's just stories. Stories to tell the kids to keep you in your place.
Junk's the best. That's why the doctors keep it for themselves.
He's really gonna miss out on a chance. It's better than anything else in the whole world.
Oh, more for us.
Go on.
Go on.
Go out with me.
Yeah.
I always believe that didn't work.
You're gonna live with us now, both of you. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sometimes I look out the window at all the straights crawling past. Going to work, coming back from work. Going to learn how to work, whatever. And I want to shout, hey, it's not like that. It really isn't like that. Only, I never do. It's useless. They must weigh about 60,000 tons. I'm so far removed from people like that. It's like, they can't even see me. Listen. You can be anything you want to be. Be careful, it's a spell, it's magic. You can be anything, you can be anyone. Listen to the magic. You are anything. Anything you want. I've done everything. You think it, I've done it. Anything you ever dreamt, anything you ever dared, anything you were curious about, but then forgot because you knew you never would. I didn't. I didn't yesterday while you were still in bed. When is it going to be you? When is it going to be your turn?
A 15-minute interval. We ask you kindly to leave the dead space.
That's Deb the dealer.
She don't go out much, but sometimes just sits by the fire and was. Join her. Join. And there's Sal. Oh, Sal, she's right on my wavelength. She's almost as close as me and Lily. Almost. Deb's... He does a lot. He's a casualty, really. But I mean, you get casualties. Life is a dangerous business.
When she took me back, I was so happy. I mean, I was just so happy. And then when she came back, she was in love with me just as much as I was in love with her. We were all in love with one another. We were in love with ourselves, and we still are.
When I think about how close I came to chucking him, it was a close thing. I just thought everything had to be different since I met Rob and Lily. It was them who talked me out of it.
Hey, Dan. Got a look after him, you feel, can't you see that?
You're right. We've got each other. He's mine, and I'm his.
I still love her. But it's different now.
Like, I don't need her anymore, if you know what I mean. If she chucked me now, yeah, I'd still be really upset, but I know that I just get on with my life. Back then it felt like the end of the world. There I was, scrambling and struggling to keep my shit together. These days, I just let it go.
Junk is the best. I mean, the best. You've got to be sort of like special to use it. You could sit in a sewer all day and feel so happy. But drugs are dangerous. They're magic. But dangerous. So is life.
I do worry about Gemma sometimes. I mean, I can take or leave the stuff, but she never says no. Of course we don't use needles, we've got more sense than that. I just gotta remember I escaped my mum and dad once, and if I can get away from them, well, I can get away from anything.
We're all like, broke. Like, skin. We've been having a bit of a binge that week. Too much, really. But like, it's good to do too much once in a while. But, Christ, after a junk binge, you feel it. You feel horrible. You really just feel horrible.
Work for yourself in the street corner. One is easy. Same as everyone's easy once you
know how.
You didn't. You're putting my leg, aren't you?
Look, I was a little posy half an hour, and now I'm a lily. And I'm having a really good time.
Next month, I'm going on a trip to Southeast Asia. Cycling it all. Can you believe it? Cycling through Bali, and Thailand, then Australia. You should come with me, Tar. Why not?
I haven't got any money.
Doesn't matter. I'll lend you some.
Come on. You know I couldn't pay you back even if I wanted to.
Oh, Tar,
you just want me to leave the junk alone.
I would really like it if you did.
But it is the junk, innit?
It'll kill you. It's killing you. No, you're really boring these days.
So are you. I don't need to go cycling in Southeast Asia to keep myself interested, Richard.
Well, I hope you find it just as interesting being dead as you have been being found it being alive.
Oh, I'm just trying to live my life. And if that means I'll be dead in 3 years, then so be it. Oh, fuck no. Send me a postcard, Rich.
Could a week some weeks if I go for it. 15 years old, 300 quid a week. I keep thinking, I'd like to go back and tell my parents, not what I'm doing, or how I'm doing, just me. Just show them me, so that they know I'm doing all right.
Lily has to take them as they come, straight off the street. Of course, the management don't want people to get turned away. So you can't say, don't fancy him, I'll have him instead. But if they ask you to do something, you know, kinky, they send in Joe, and he shows them the door, and the boss Gordon. It's pretty good too, if you know what I mean.
Only I can't go back. I'm a junkie. I need to be clean before I do that. I do too much, I know I do. It's driving me crazy. I can't speak to them. I miss my mum, but I can't speak to her. But like, it's not like she's gonna die tomorrow, right?
It's a public service, really. After the bank holidays, you get this queue of men in the waiting area. If it weren't for us, they'd probably be out on the street hunting down young girls. Me and Gemma have this joke about it. You on PPD today?
Yeah, pervert prevention duty.
told a doctor yet? Has he given you a date? Listen, miss, sister. Know what the pigs do? They come back and haunt. Yeah, I see them. Floating on the ceilings, looking for their mums. Because their mums had them scraped out and they never got alive. I'm not going to kill my baby. No one is going to kill my baby.
I didn't say kill it, Mel.
Listen, we're going to have it. A baby, Jen.
You're on the game. And you're a junkie. Lily, you ought to have an abortion.
Because you did. Are you telling me to kill my baby? Are you telling me? You ought to have an abortion for the sake of the baby. You want me to kill my baby? You want me to kill my baby? Come on then, you do it. You kill it now. Your baby is a junkie. Your baby is inside you and full of junk. Same as you. Is that how much you love your bloody baby?
You're calling me a junkie? You're calling me a fucking junkie?
I'm telling you it's unfair to be pregnant with your baby while you're full of junk. What sort of mother is that?
I can give up any sum of one.
Don't have any. Sorry, babe. God, I think I better go.
No.
No, don't go. She'll be alright. She'll be alright.
See? She'll be fine.
And so's Gems. And we're all gonna get clean and live a good life. You're not gonna come round too junked up, and you're not gonna give me junk when I'm pregnant.
No, definitely no.
Everything's gotta change. You don't do junk when there's babies. We'll have a baby in the house by Christmas.
I'm gonna get a job. I'm all gonna move off to City Road. But let's face it, it's pretty squalid.
I'm going to come off the game and I'm going to go veg in the garden and have chickens and everything.
Rob and I are going to build a swing in the garden. Just like the little one for the baby. And we're doing the skits for a cop with that baby shirt.
I'm thinking we're going to stop doing tricks at work. Just full sex. Don't earn as much but you still do alright.
I was doubtful at first. But now I'm just as keen as everyone. It's a real chance. Me and Gems are even talking about having babies of our own.
And me and Gems are gonna knit. Imagine us knitting.
And the first thing, the big thing, is we're all gonna get off junk. The way I see it, we had a love affair, but me and junk, we're over. It just feels so right that we all get let out of it by a little baby. Like baby Jesus.
Yeah, but baby's different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Did I tell you? Lily took Lou the other day.
Baby, that was the real magic spell. And Lily was the witch who was making it. What does that make me? A magician, I suppose. It is a bit like that. Me, a dad, with my magic wand. We were away for a whole week. A whole week. Miles from anywhere. Beautiful Welsh countryside. People, you know, hassle. No problems. The cottage belonged to a friend of Wendy's. Wendy's my mum. It was April, so it was free. And we finished off the last of our jump before we set out. And we had a tiny bit, a dab, just to get us through the night. So in the morning, we could start right from scratch. Personally, I was determined to have a real go at it. I had a little package in my pocket that no one knew about. And I almost thought about throwing it away. But I didn't want to muck things up. And now out of my mind, but you have to find the best way of going about things. That little package, it was just right for me. We went for a walk over the hill and down into the valley beyond.
You gave her some. What about your baby, Lily? For Christ's sake, what about your baby?
You murderer!
Your baby, Lily, for Christ's sake. I'd have done it too if just one of you bastards had hung out with me.
Well, go on then. Give me some. Give me some, will you?
Well, I couldn't say no, could I? I thought, this is no fun. We never spent a second night at Wendy's cottage.
All the way back.
I should have just taken a bit with me.
Rob did.
I thought so.
Why don't you just ask him, instead of hitching all the way back?
I don't know! Don't fucking get at me! How do you think I feel about it?
What does it matter anyway?
Look, I only went along with the plan because the rest of you were so clean. I cleared off so I didn't tempt you. Live fast, die young, you know, Jack.
Well, you don't really think
you
like that!
You don't reason about it when you're dead!
Never name or junk for daddy! You never even do anything to that sordid dandelion anymore!
Not prison. My case don't come up for another 3 months. This is the detox centre in Western Supermare. The first thing they did was they got all the new intake together and told us what was what. There were about 10 of us sitting around in a circle. And this funny hippie looking woman, I thought she was one of us till she started talking.
No one's keeping you here. Anytime you feel had enough, there's the door. But while you do stay here, no drugs of any kind are allowed. Not even aspirin. Not even hash. I like smoke, and if I can go without it, so can you. If any of you feel you just can't do it, it'd be better go now. Really, go now, and you can come back another time. Wait until you get caught, you're blowing it forever. If you get taken drugs taken here, you will never come back.
Tar writes to me every day. Those words on the bottom he writes.
Dandelion, I love you.
I thought that was magic.
Loving someone. It's not you and it's not them. It's not in you, it's between you. It's bigger and stronger than you are.
Dandelion.
Dandelion. That's all I have left to believe in. And it's the only hope I have left to save me.
Come on, Tad, just another few weeks and you will be clean.
All I want is junk. I just want to leave.
Do you want something to help you?
What do you mean?
I can't give you heroin, but I have some methadone for severe cases.
Why are you methadone?
Heroin is in need of a methadone, isn't it?
Yeah, please.
Okay, I'll go get it, but you have to leave.
What?
If you want some, you can have it, but you have to leave.
Just fuck off! I was out on the grounds the other day. I came across this bush that was full of red berries, and it was blazing. And the air smelled like leaves and soil. The colour was so bright it hurt my eyes. Not like coming down when bright colours are really unpleasant. I'm clean now. It was just a blaze of red. It felt like I was looking at something for the first time in 3 years. I thought all that time, junk had been in between me and the world around me. Like a fat cushion that you can't see through, or hear through, or touch through. It's like 3 years that never were.
Brainwashed. They've done a great job on you, mate. Took you off one drug and put you on another.
Oh, leave him alone, Lily. He's doing all right.
They put him in prison, all right. They locked you up inside your own prison and gave you the key. And how did you get out of that jail? They made you your own jailer. It's cheaper for them that way.
Think what you want, Lily. You're a junk and I'm not.
Tom.
Well, that's all right then.
Wow. He asked. What was I supposed to do?
Well, leave him alone, Lily. It's supposed to be a party.
Look at him. He's practically gouging out.
I only did a shake. I didn't even use the needle.
Leave him alone, Lily. It's supposed to be his fucking party.
It doesn't mean I haven't given up.
Oh, dear.
Wait, so you're still using, but you've given up, sure.
Well, it's alright, because we're at a party. Anyway, Gemma did something. She asked me if it was alright.
And you said yes?
Don't tell me. You know it won't do her any good.
You want me to play in your little games? How are you going to feel about this tomorrow?
I think I'd fancy a bit of junk food.
Really fun it up for both of you!
See me. He helped me move into my new place in Reading. I asked him if he was clean. I didn't want any needles in the house. He seemed slightly offended when I asked him. It was his usual shifty self. Not that it was unusual since he got onto joke. It's funny, I haven't actually liked him for years. I keep getting little glimpses every now and again. He'll look at me shyly, the corner of his eye. I would sit there and think to myself that the old tower was still in there, somewhere. Where are you off to?
I'm going back. I've just got to get back. Can you lend me a bus fare?
Nothing else I can do
today. No, I'm sorry. I just gotta get back. Or only hitch home if you don't give me the money. I'm coming down, Richard. I'm doing a cold turkey, but I can't move through with it. I'm sorry.
What did you just say?
I didn't want to tell you I was coming down. Look, I'll only just go and hitch home. I can't do it. Not this time, Richard. I beg.
Wait, Charles, there's nothing else I can do!
Look at me! Just look at me, Richard! I'm nothing but a junkie! I'm just a junkie! I'm just a junkie! I'm just a fucking junkie! And I just need to go home and get some shit and get home with it! I'm just a junkie! I'm just a fucking junkie!
Sonny the baby. They live a few streets away. I don't know why I love him so much. He's a bastard now, really. He lies. He cheats. He steals money right from out my purse. And he nicks our stash and only comes back when he's finished it. Then his eyes, they sort of swivel about a bit. And he tells me that he loves me. I don't know how true that is anymore. I want to have Tar's baby. That's really stupid, isn't it? Want me to have it, and I don't know. I had to lie down, and I sat and I thought for a long time about everything. About Tar, about Lily and Rob and little Sonny, baby. You look in that poor baby's eyes, he's full of it. Junk, I mean. He's a junkie. He's been a junkie his whole little life. He was a junkie even before he was born. But the crazy thing was is that this baby, my baby, felt like the only thing worth having in the whole world.
Do that, Gems.
Oh, it's fine, you fell asleep and I just wanted to help.
No one is going to take my baby away from me. No one is going to take my baby!
I never said that. I never said that, Lily.
He's a lovely baby, Gems.
Yeah, you're right, Lil.
Yeah. I've had it. I'm going to bed.
Oh, all right.
It'll be all right.
Yeah, well.
Night.
Good night, girl. badminton. Me and my bloke John, I stayed over his last night, and when I came back today, one of the neighbours said this punk type has been hanging around my doorstep for hours and hours. One of the really scabby ones. It wasn't even till 6 in the evening I discovered the note. I mean, she must have pushed it through the letterbox, but there's this little piece of carpet I use as a mat, and sometimes the letters get stuck underneath it. I can't wait any longer. I need to go to the hospital and try and get them to admit to me. Gemma, I hadn't seen her for ages. It just got worse around there, just full of brain-dead zombies. I used to go around and nag her. She was boosting about being on the game and using needles. I jumped into the car and I drove straight there. She looked like death. As I was standing here listening to her story, I kept thinking, she is 18 and I'm 24, but she is so much older than I am. She's an addict. She's fallen in love. She's slept with dozens of men. She's pregnant. And yet I feel like I was listening to an old, old woman telling me stories about her as a young girl. Gemma, give me your parents' number. Let's try that first. Good?
Yes, hello?
It's about your daughter, Gemma.
My first thought was, my God, she looks like my mother. Despite everything, I still thought of her as a four-year-old girl. She looked like my mother, my own mother. I wanted to make it as normal as possible for her. Talk about home and ask her what she'd done. Bill, how on earth we could talk about what she'd done those years. I don't know. I didn't want to cry, and I knew that I shouldn't. But I thought of all the things I missed and couldn't help it. I didn't get half of what I planned on saying out. She started to weep. She was crying too. I knew it was all right when she started to cry. It set everything for us.
Clean for over 3 months now. I might not have done it myself out of choice, but I'm clean, and that's the important thing. Gemma did her cold turkey at home, and well, that was that. But with my history, you can't rush it. You have to be positive before you can try anything, like the doctor said. Last time I saw Gemma, she was as big as a house. She'd gotten bigger and bigger every single time she came to see me. Now she's bringing home our baby, Una. Love is forever. Well, I don't believe that anymore. Being an addict will last forever. But it was a love story. For me, Gemma, and Junk.
Do it for 2 hours. Yeah? Deal? Deal, parents? Yeah, okay. Thank you, bye!